Everybody, I'm Allison.
I'm Julia.
And we're with the Winkle, and today we're making Santa Zip Line! Juliet, it's that time of year when Santa's gonna be coming pretty soon. How do you think Santa gets around the world so fast in one day?
Because of his sled is so fast and his reindeers.
Do you think he uses a zip line to get around really fast? Maybe. Have you ever been on a zip line?
No.
No.
I'm too little.
You are pretty little. I've been on a zip line and it went so fast that my eyes were watering. Because I was like, oh! Well, today we're gonna make Santa's sleigh and put it on a zip line. Isn't that gonna be so fun?
Yes!
Yes! Let's see what's in our kit.
A stencil, glitter paper, pipe cleaner, plastic candy canes, a straw, two ornament hooks, some jingle bells, and fishing line, and glue dots.
Once you have that, you'll just need a pencil or a pen and a pair of scissors. And we're ready to get started. Juliet, get out your stencil first and we're gonna cut this out to make Santa's sleigh. If at any time in these Winkle videos we get too far ahead of you, sometimes we fast forward or we just go faster, you can always pause the video and catch up with us when you're ready. If you don't understand one of the instructions, you can always rewind the video and press play and watch it again. When you're cutting out Santa's sleigh stencil, you wanna go on the outside of that black line. It's okay if you mess up a little bit. This is just a stencil that we're cutting out, but try and go on the outside of that black line the best that you can. Okay, we have our stencil out. What does it kind of look like right now?
A butterfly.
Yeah, a butterfly also flies through the sky, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Okay, for this next part, you need your pencil and your glitter paper. You're going to put your stencil on the white side of your glitter paper. Make sure that it's right there where it's not touching any of the edges. You don't want it to overlap any of the edges. And you're going to trace around that black line. And I'm gonna show you a little trick when you're tracing a paper, is that you wanna put your fingers right where you're tracing so that the paper doesn't slip. And you wanna get right up to that black line. If you start going away from that line like this, that's not gonna work. You just wanna get back to, you don't even need to erase that line right there. Just get back to where you should be. If your pencil accidentally slips and goes under your sleigh, you don't need to erase that either. No one's gonna notice it, no one's gonna see it. Just gonna go nicely along this line and see how I'm keeping my fingers right there so that my pencil doesn't go under the stencil. Do you see these dots right here?
Yeah.
That's kind of where we want the dots to be on our Santa sleigh. So if you can just take your pencil while your sleigh is still lined up, take your pencil and push it through those dots. That's gonna help us a lot later. You wanna make sure not to push your fingers. So what you do is you lift up your stencil and your paper just a little bit and you poke the pencil through. Don't put your fingers behind there because you don't wanna poke your fingers. Just lift it up and poke it through. Okay, now we have that all traced and we can cut it out. This is going to take a little bit more effort from your little fingers to cut out because this paper is called cardstock, so it's a thicker paper than what you're used to cutting, but it's better for the Santa sleigh because the sides of the sleigh will stand up a lot better than if you just had it on regular paper. Just take your time, get into those corners nicely, just use the tip of your scissors if you need to. Take your time to go all the way around because unlike the stencil, this is your actual sleigh. So this is the part that you wanna get as perfectly as you can. Get it just right. Nice and slow, we're not in a hurry.
The cardstock is so hard.
It's so hard to cut, but it's gonna look so good when it's done.
Yeah.
Wow, this is so pretty looking.
And
I love
it. Still looks like a butterfly.
It does. Turn that sleigh over so you can see the white side again, and take one of the scrap pieces of paper that you just cut and line up these edges right here. See these corners? You're gonna line those up, draw a line across, and these other corners right here, line those up too. Because those are gonna be the bottom of the sleigh where he puts his feet and the presents and stuff
yep,
like that.
That looks more like a butterfly.
So now we're going to fold this on that line that we just did.
So like you fold this part back?
I feel like it's easier to bend it that way.
Or do you do it like this?
Look, if you bend it back like that, it bends really easily. And then you can bend it back the other way. Yep, and then you're gonna bend it the right way. So it's like Santa's sleigh. Now you're gonna need two pieces of straw. So take your straw and you are going to cut it right there. See how wide across this is? That's exactly the length of straw you need. So cut that. Whoa! And then cut it one more time. So you have two pieces the same length. Okay, now you're going to take one of your pieces of pipe cleaner. It doesn't matter which color. Yep. You're going to push it through the glittery side of your Santa sleigh at the top, right there. You see that? Good. Now take a piece of your straw and push it through, and then take the other side of your Santa sleigh and push the pipe cleaner through that. And then just line up your pipe cleaner so it's nice and even. Here, you're gonna do the same thing to the other side of your Santa sleigh. Take another piece of pipe cleaner, push it through, put a piece of straw on the pipe cleaner, and then push the pipe cleaner through to the other side. Then pull it through. Okay, so your Santa sleigh should kind of look like this so far. Now we're going to tie the pipe cleaner together.
Oh,
and it's so easy because it just is wire that you're twisting together. You're gonna twist it like this together and just keep twisting until it all twists together. See how I made a circle like that? That's kind of what you're looking for. I'll show you on the other side. So we're gonna twist, like we're gonna have it overlap and have like bunny ears. And then it's gonna go under and over, like that.
Mommy, I kind of did it.
Yeah, and if you do a twist like Juliet's, that is totally fine too. That will work just fine. Well, we all know that Santa's sleigh can't go dashing through the snow without something on the bottom of his sleigh.
Yeah.
Yes. So we need to put on the candy canes. Do you think Santa has real candy canes on the bottom of his sleigh?
No!
But he should, because he's Santa. That would be so fun, right?
He's Santa of Candyland.
So I'm going to show you guys how to put the candy canes, not real candy canes. Do not eat them. No. I'm going to show you how to put them on the bottom of your Santa sleigh. Okay, you all have glue dots, and you're going to need three glue dots on the bottom of your sleigh. So if you tear like that and get three in a row, that will be the easiest. Some people have never used glue dots before, so I'm going to show you how to do it. You're going to take up the plastic part away from the paper, like that. Peel that paper off, set it aside. Now you're going to put the glue dots on one side of your sleigh. Try and put it on one side, and then we'll put the other line of glue dots on the other side. So I kind of smash it down with my fingernail, as you see, like that. And then when I'm peeling up this plastic, I have to kind of hold the glue dot with my thumb a little bit while I'm peeling up the plastic, like that. Now you don't want to touch these glue dots because you have oil on your fingers, and oil will make the glue dots not sticky anymore. You have extra glue dots just in case one of them turns into a booger like Juliet did. So no problems. So don't peel the glue dots off of the paper. Try and just not touch them. You're gonna rub them onto your glitter paper and then pull the plastic up.
Just
hold it down with your thumb. Nice and easy. You have extras in case you mess up.
If it turns like into a booger like mine, then you can just have an extra. And it's okay. Mistakes are great.
Yeah, mistakes are totally fine, especially with the Winkle. We make mistakes all the time. Yeah. And we just learn from it and then we move on, right?
And because if you mess up and try a different way, it'll just help you learn more.
That's exactly right. Okay, so take your candy cane. And remember how Santa has a sleigh, so you don't want to put your candy cane that way because that would not help him glide through the snow, and that way would be backwards. So you want the candy cane facing
this
straight
way?
Up, uh-huh, and push it really hard on those blue dots to make it nice and stuck on there. We're going to take three more glue dots. If you have three in a row, that's great. If not, you can just do them one by one, and we're going to put it on the other side. Press them down really good. Watch right here, you're gonna press that glue dot down and then I hold it down with my thumb and peel the plastic off. Then we're gonna put our candy cane on there. Just, these are called parallel lines because they are lines that go side by side and they're never gonna run into each other. They're never gonna crisscross because they're perfectly parallel. So that's what you're trying to get on Santa's sleigh, are two parallel lines with those candy canes. Now that is starting to look like Santa's sleigh.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, when you're dealing with a zip line, Juliet, one of the science things we're trying to figure out is called mass. Okay, so the mass can be the object that's in the zip line, in the sleigh, or if you put something on the front of it and you're playing around with the weight, okay, of the mass. So what weight is gonna, is the weight gonna make it go slower? Is the weight gonna make it go faster? If you put the weight in the back, will it go faster? Or if you put the weight in the front, will it go faster? Or will it go faster with less weight altogether? These are the kind of things I want you to explore with your own zip line at home. So one of the things we have for you for weights is jingle bells. So we're gonna attach our jingle bells to the front of our sleigh first and see if that makes the sleigh go faster or slower. So for the jingle bells, you can just thread your last pipe cleaner that you have through the top of the jingle bell. These also help to decorate the sleigh and make a fun jingling sound that makes it sound like Christmas. You can choose to do one, two, or all of your bells. It's up to you. That sounds like Santa. I'm gonna attach these to the front of my sleigh just to see what happens. Now when you're building a zip line, if you're an engineer that builds a zip line, you might need to slow the zip line down. As a kid, you might think, well, why would I ever want to slow the zip line down? I just want to go fast, fast, fast all the time. But as an engineer, you might have to slow the zip line down because you can't have people go 100 miles an hour down the zip line. They could get hurt. So once you have those bells on the front, you can cut off the rest of the pipe cleaner if you want. Again, this is your project. Now the other thing when we're talking about a zip line, Juliet, is friction. High friction or low friction. So we have these two ornament hooks, and we're gonna, these are just wire. We're gonna tie them around our pipe cleaner. You just hook it around and then you're just going to pinch it closed like that. Friction means two objects that are sliding together. So if we have the pipe cleaner going down the zip line, see how the pipe cleaner's kind of fuzzy? That would create a lot of friction. That would be high friction because there's a lot of material there that's gonna be sliding along our zip line. But we want low friction so that our zip line goes faster, right? So feel this fishing line. Is it really smooth?
Yeah.
Yes. And then feel the wire, the ornament hook. Is it really smooth?
Yes. Yeah.
So those are gonna create low friction, which means there's not a lot that's gonna hold the sleigh back from going fast down the zip line. Okay, the last part we need to learn about the zip line is about the actual line. So we already learned that the line has very low friction, which means it's super slippery and our sleigh will go down it really fast. But we also need to talk about gravity and slope. So gravity is the force that pulls us to the middle of the earth, right? It brings us down. So that's what's gonna cause the sleigh to go down. It's gonna go start from up here and go down. So you'll need to attach it to something in your house or outside that's high up, maybe a kitchen knob or a doorknob or something like that, and attach it down low to like the leg of a chair or a stool. Be creative. I'm sure you have plenty of things in your house that you can use this on. Yes, as long as one side is up high and the other side is down low. So you wanna play with the slope. This is called the slope. So if you do it up really high, that'd be a high slope. And it might go super fast, right? Yes, it might go too fast. So then you might wanna adjust it to maybe go here or maybe down like this. You're gonna play with the slope and see where the slope is just right so that it's right where you want it for your sleigh, okay? If your slope isn't high enough, your sleigh might not go very fast at all. In fact, it might just stop on the zip line altogether. Are we ready to try our Santa sleigh and see if it works? Okay, here we go.
Whoa! Can I try mine?
Whoa! We had so much fun making this Santa sleigh with you today, didn't you, Juliet? Just in time for Christmas. And thank you so much for joining us. If you have a grown-up take a picture or video of you with your sleigh, we would love to see it and see how it turned out. Have them post it on social media and tag us at the Winkle Crate. That way we can see your sleigh and how it turned out. Yep. Thanks for joining us today, everybody. Bye.
Bye.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.